and welcome back to Mario Plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope. Last time, we pretty much did every single side quest that we can do currently in Palette Prime, and sadly could not get to the other area. We also happened to get these two to hook up, apparently? That happened? But, I believe we should head off to the next area, and I think it, what was it, like, the flower themed, I think? Let's find out. Terra Flora. All right.
We're approaching Terra Flora, home to naturally sparkling mineral water springs, perennial flower prairies, not to mention the ever-blossom tree. Surely, Genie, even you can't spoil my enthusiasm for visiting the Garden of the Galaxy.
Unfortunately, I believe I can. Cursa's stronghold is now in range of our ship's instruments.
What?
Cursa has constructed a barrier of darkness energy around it that will prevent us from landing our spaceship there.
Joy!
Even if we do find enough purified darkness energy to reach it.
And you must know a way.
What? How's that?
You know Bedrock. You know Midnight. There is something you are choosing not to tell us, isn't there?
Listen!
It might be helpful, though.
About those flower prairies. It looks like we are going to see them in person. Prepare for landing?
Oh? Hi? No! Oh! Oh my. Okay, they're alive. See a lot of flowers.
Terra Flora's foliage is suffering.
Really?
A drought is looming. Terra Flora's famous water volcano, Mount Spout, has gone dormant.
Hello there.
that voice.
Wait.
Her name is Jeannie, our ship's artificially intelligent pilot and systems manager, and I am...
curse upon thee.
Oh dear.
Actually, while enjoyment of my duties is immaterial, I find them quite pleasurable, Mr.
Curse me for an unmannerly pig. Whoa, steam power.
Yeah, that looks like a problem.
Car run out of cucumber canapes is a trifling problem. That is a darkness tentacle.
Boy, snub. However,
thank you, okay. Mr. Sullivan. We will visit the Everbloom tree right away and see your train soon, I promise.
Alrighty then. Stay on track. Probably won't. I'll probably do a lot of side quests first, because that's just me. Come on over here.
I like Terra Flora's chances at the planet-shaped cheese ball cup. They sign some good crumble whackers in the off-season.
Interesting. I guess I go in here. I'm totally not gonna get lost around here. Heh. I see new baddies. Yeah, this could work. I guess. Everyone went boom. It's better than this first. Well. Oh my god. Sure.
Swish.
Yeah, put you here. There we go.
Bye, kitty.
You boom. See? You go boom. Meh. Let's do this. Heh, that kind of worked. I'm gonna do this. And I don't need to hit the barrel, but yay!
Funky Fresh with Rabbid Luigi.
Level up. We're off to a great start. That won't end at all. Interesting. Upgraded.
How do I upgrade it?
Where are you going? What is that? Okay. Okay. Did not knock any of them over. Come on. Got it. I guess do this. You three. Bye bye. Bye. And bye. I'm gonna do this. Dead. Yee! Just die. Can we talk about this? Yes.
It's the Phantom's Gold Gramophone Award for Best Opera Album. 1,000 hours of Mario falling into lava.
Interesting taste. Okay.
Tree itself.
I guess to say the universe?
We mean you no harm. In fact, we can help restore your majestic Everbloom to its natural, efflorescing state.
Okay.
Yes, of course, oh great spirit of the Everbloom. Thank you. You won't regret it.
Hopefully.
Wait.
Heh. Okay.
Yo.
Oh boy, more pictures.
Oh yeah!
Bia's first solo album was corporate produced teen pop drivel. I mean, really, who listens to that rubbish?
Your playlist has 6 different live versions of this album, including a remastered one that was released last week, Beepo.
Heh. Called out.
Experimental album done entirely underwater.
Cool.
Critics dared to call it an artistic temper tantrum appealing only to pseudo-intellectual snobs. Honestly, I loved it.
Okay. Good.
I got it. Speed.
Here we go. This one.
Speed donuts.
There we go.
Oh yeah.
Bia is a survivor. With her singing career over, she retired to Terra Flora and began a new life as an organic farmer. Thankfully, we have lots of great albums to remember Bia's beautiful voice. Just not this one. Yeah, she sounds like a rusty chainsaw.
Oh no, it's you.
At last! Speaking of...
That's a good for me this time.
A chuch, a puff, a gasp. Can you?
Can I even do this right now? Hmm. see, where do I move this? Over here? Can I not bring this over here? Okay. Guess move that there.
Speed donuts. Whoop whoop.
I got this.
Oh yeah!
Yep. Okay, so move that over there. Yep. It goes like that. Okay. Oh, now I can push it across. Think ahead.
Speed donuts.
Do that. See. This is gonna be a process. Gonna move you back over here. I'm gonna move this. And put you over here. Gonna put you on this thing. Put that back. gonna move you over here.
Speed donuts!
To back.
Whoop whoop!
Here we go. Can't, come on, go in. Yeah. Come on. There we go. That was a lot easier than the last one.
Oh yeah. Yes, yes, yes.
Let's continue. Okay. These guys again, and new ones. Okay.
Bye.
See you over here. Might as well do this. Yeah. I guess.
Go on.
My god. Yeah. Got it.
Finally.
Woo!
A whole new generation was exposed to Mia when she became a celebrity host for the annual Galactovision Song Contest. Unfortunately, the Phantom was her co-host. The two constantly tried to outshine each other, eventually ruining their voices. Mia sang the Beacon Beach Brawler's entrance music live for his Galaxy Wrestling title bout at Galactomania. It was the first of many ill-advised comeback attempts, although she did develop one heck of a sunset pile driver. Got another one. This album during her punk pop phase after a whirlwind relationship with the Phantom. Silly celebrity nonsense, really. I can't believe he dumped her at the Galaxy Music Awards by text during her acceptance speech. I'll never forgive him.
That seems a bit mean, yeah?
A wiser, more mature Bia grew into her own with this album, which critics called soulful and masterfully crafted. It sold only 300 copies and effectively ended her career.
Aww. It's still decent, though. Put that down.
I'm going to ignore that and go this way. What I get. Gimme.
Sweet.
Where does this take me? Oh my. Going up here. How do I do that?
Yeah.
All right.
Ow. Oh yeah.
Aha. Oh, I just noticed that. I'm gonna be sneaky. Watch me.
Speed donuts.
What'd I get?
Wowzers.
Okay, that's what he looks like.
We have yet to meet a warden who did not fascinate, and Terra Flora's Bia is no exception. A popular entertainer since a tender young age, when her career came to a halt, she could have wallowed in excess or let bitterness consume her. Instead, she reinvented herself as a flower farmer whose bouquets make hearts swell all over the galaxy, just as her music once did.
Aww. Let's do this now. Hello there. Hmm. I suppose I said upgrade too. Yeah?
It's on!
I can get three of them. Made it over here. Yeah.
Yawn.
Yeah.
Creep.
Yeah. Ow, are you not dead? Do it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I guess put you here. Yeah. Sir. Yeah. Sneaky. Okay. Where are you gonna be headed? Of course. Too bad.
It's just lovely.
Okay. Oh, there she is. Hi.
Spirit of the Everbloom?
Oh, honey.
That's a lot of Z's.
You must know where we can find the darkness that's infiltrated Terra Flora.
Mount Spout. Oh. Flowers, flowers. My sweet.
Uh. Oh boy, here we go again.
Whoa. Sonic powers upgraded.
Here we go.
I see why you called him Drizzle. He certainly made a splash with me.
Drizzle? Our flowers.
Sweet. Here we go.
The great Kolachinski. No one combined their love of music and bouncing uncontrollably to great heights more effectively. He's in coin heaven now.
Okay. Kaboom! How far can I get you? Still not far. Wow! That was like one turn! Hello? Oh, oh my. Eesh. I'm not liking the looks of this. Sure. People used to be used to this by now. 35 coins. Fine. Two.
Whoosh!
I picked it up. I can't remember how many I needed. Please tell me it was like 7. Still did it though. What did I need? Oh, I needed 8. I got 7. Guess I'm not out of here. Okay, I'm out of time for today. Guess we'll continue next time. So, if you enjoyed, please leave a like, maybe comment, and perhaps subscribe. See you all next time.